Hello everyone, and welcome back to LA-MULANA. When we last left off, we were really close to the end, actually.
Just like.
We do have the best shield ever now. So let's go back to the Chamber of Earth, which I think was through... No, it wasn't through here. I messed up. I need to go for the gun first. Oh, come on. If I remember correctly, Chamber of the entrance closest to that was over here.
Hey, be careful.
Yeah, that's why you need the in your shield.
Yeah,
now we have. There is a vessel made of silver. Use it when with the item button to fill it with medicine. Can't really do that just yet. Another thing we need to go check before it's too late is the Shrine of the Mother. Because we did go speak with the fourth philosopher and the ladder he opens is this way.
Batman still does not give a flying fuck.
Yeah, not yet. He will soon, probably.
Maybe.
Maybe, possibly. Could be happening right now.
Clearly not, you're not kicking his ass.
There it is. Who is it that reads this? Is it my son? I could only hope so. I have come this far, but the four philosophers did not choose me. I wasn't up to the task. I could not awaken the mother. I am too old. Whoever is reading this, I pass the torch to you. The hidden treasure, the origin of life itself, lies here. Oh yeah, and remember to turn the power off when you're finished reading.
He does.
Mm-hmm. I mean, why not?
I mean, I would at least take it with me.
We already got a bit of the computer.
Yeah, but you know, keepsakes, you know, sentimentality.
Well, I'm gonna go ahead and heal up again because we're definitely gonna need it. And now we're missing one item and one required program. Also one orb of life, but minor details. So go back to the dimensional corridor.
Also, the fact that your father gets that far implies that the boss is doing chapter spawn.
Yeah.
Unless he just somehow got past all of them without killing any bosses.
It's like, how did we get there?
Yeah.
Okay, this was one of the places where I need to... Kinda complicated. Sadly, I also don't remember the exact locations. There's some kind of weird ritual you need to do to trigger the last mini boss opening. The interdimensional key, the place that eternally connects to the place where life is born, we know it. across the infinity there. So yeah, that's the clue to actually get the dimensional key so the monster stops spawning. And it's right there, it's like, how much of an asshole do they need to be, right? You know what? You're an asshole. Hidden ladder there that you can use. Also, I think that was also a place where I. And what am I doing? I can just check. A4, D5, C4, D3. So A4 was where that first statue was. D5, so. Two, three, four, five. Okay. So this one. C40. Oh wait, I think it has to be in order. Maybe? I don't know, but the other place it says is D3. Which would be right above. How do you get up there? Well, I can't go there now, so. Alright. Two vessels. Those two pillars look strangely familiar, don't they?
You don't say.
Road to Threshold. You might as well take a screenshot of the mostly coste drawing. Tells you where the last of the hilltops is. But it's the secret room up there, like the topmost one. Best way to beat this guy, especially not without the length of time. So we just have to move carefully, I guess. I get hammered by it. Don't take that out of context. Okay, this doesn't seem too difficult. I just need to wait for it to go down. Oh, come on. It's like it knows I'm waiting for it.
Well, of course.
That was close. Yeah, I hit it. Open up now. Oh, yeah, it does. Cool. But first, let's go heal and refill the lamp of time. No.
Hey, man. Watch out for the spikes.
Thanks.
I'll try to help. Well, I hope that worked. This is the 5. Yeah. Alright, let me check the Adion just in case. Yeah, okay, so. Now we need to go to C4. Right here. Maybe I need to beat the one at the top first, which is gonna be awkward because we actually need him to get to the orb.
And this is why I say it. Gotten so lucky at the beginning.
Now he has a giraffe, he doesn't want to play the player game anymore.
Yeah, basically. No. Oh, you thought I was done with that?
Ahaha. Very funny.
Well, this is gonna be your suffering. At least the road to get there is pretty clear. And just reloading the game is, makes it decently easy to just get there and try again. I'm so glad this kind of bullshit isn't part of the second game. There's various other kinds of bullshit, but I can handle those. Glad I didn't pause time. Moved a bit too quickly for that one. There we go. Use the other path. This, I'm getting better at it. You know, practice makes perfect and all of that, right?
Yeah, totally.
So probably should have just saved after selecting the lamp of time. Easy to line myself up for the right position because of that red light and all of that. That does make it a bit difficult to time the last jump, just with the monster right in between. Might take a few tries. Alright, I'm just gonna go ahead and do this before I forget. Not even gonna give a shit about the bats. I got some pretty badass music to deal with this. Oh no. Stupid trigger finger. I was so happy. It was almost perfect. Took too long to activate it. Not even gonna consider that one. I need all of the HP I have for that freaking jump after all. Don't forget, after that we still need to actually beat him!
So, just out of curiosity, did you intend to do anything else this episode?
I thought it was a possibility. So, not sure if you noticed, but there isn't a way out of this room.
No kidding.
Which means not only do we have to get the orb, we need to beat him in order to open the way out.
Yep.
I'm not very used to the grappling hook controls sometimes. Yeah, because of that. You know what? Fuck it, I'll take it. Maxed out HP. We just have to beat that thing again. Oh well, we didn't gain it, I suppose. Well, I didn't expect that to completely kill him, but it's probably a start.
Once more, with feeling.
That's a word for it. Hey, we managed to get it. We can do it again. Maybe this time I won't miss one of the pistol shots. What's going on outside? I definitely didn't set the house on fire because of that. No, that was just summer. Yeah, Dad, you hear it?
Yep.
Oh shit, that's loud.
You don't say.
Well, a bit too loud to mute myself. I mean, too late. Yeah. By the time I managed to actually do that, they were kind of already gone. I'll take it. Yeah, good enough. Okay. I decided not to grab onto the one. Sometimes this game can be rather arbitrary. At least that's what I feel. Thank you. progress, probably. No point in keeping that equipped. I'm gonna go ahead and equip the gun immediately. I was just talking to the hunter for a moment. Alright, let's take this one carefully. Ow. As much as we can. I guess I could use the... Come on!
Wow. Just... how long have you been at this? Jesus.
34 minutes in total for the episode. We did do a couple things before, but... yeah, this is one of the... probably one of the parts I hate the most about the, specifically the first game. At least I'm getting lucky with the first attacks now. At least that seems to be working this time. Okay, gone. This is gonna require quite a lot of switching, isn't it? There's another part I like about the second game. It has quick sub-weapon switching too. Of course he moved right as I... At least his tail doesn't seem to have... collision.
Something.
The chakram body was totally worth it. Now, if you'll excuse me, I need to go save.
You know, before disaster strikes.
Anyway, there's not really any point in continuing the recording right now, so hope you'll have fun. And we'll see you next time. Bye bye.
Later.